We need to be patient when it comes to the hardships. And how do we exercise patience when it comes to the calamities? Firstly, we practice patience upon calamities by not complaining. This is something important you and I must understand. If we do not complain concerning the calamities and hardships that Allah Azza wa Jal has decreed for us, if we do not complain and do not speak negative words, complaining against Allah or saying words that contradict our faith and contradict the qadr, for example, saying, "Why me, Ya Allah? Why did you give me this sickness? Why did you take my child away?" All these words negate patience. You are not patient when you say words like this. So how do you remain patient in the face of calamities? By refraining from saying or doing anything that Allah Azza wa Jal has forbid us from do, and then saying, "Inna lillah wa inna ilayhi raji'un." Allahu Akbar. This is the word to be said when you are facing any calamity, any hardship, any difficulty in life. Allah Azza wa Jal, He mentions a list of calamities that can happen to a person. After this list of calamities, He said, "And give good news to the patient ones." How are we going to be patient, Ya Rab? He said, whenever a hardship strikes them or affects them, قالوا, they say, "Inna lillah wa inna ilayhi raji'un." Ask Allah, say, "Rabbana," and this is a Quranic dua, as I told you, "Rabbana afrigh alayna sabran." Oh Allah, drench us and pour upon us patience. Look how beautiful this word is. Afrigh alayna sabran. Afrigh, it's like you have a bottle in your hand and you're pouring, you're emptying it. You're saying, "Oh Allah, shower me with patience. Pour upon me patience. Drench me with patience. I want to have patience in my eyes, in my ears, in my tongue, on my hand, in my body. Everywhere I want to have patience." You want patience in your eyes so that you don't look at the haram. You want patience in your ears so that you don't hear what's haram. It is only one life you're going to live. Wallahi, one life and you're going to live and that's it. لَا يُرْجَعُونَ. They will never ever come back to it. You will never ever come back to this worldly life. It is one chance you have. One and only chance. Do what is pleasing to Allah. And then there is your nafs. And there is the evil whispering of the shaitan. That is what you're supposed to fight. Fight that evil whispering of a shaitan. The best words that would get rid of the evil whispering of a shaitan is أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. That's the best word to keep up a fight with the shaitan. And ذكر الله سبحانه وتعالى. It would keep the shaitan, his pressure upon you low. And as a result, your nafs can rise and you can experience patience upon worship. Patience concerning the sins. Whenever you're tempted by a sin, don't just give in easily to it. Hold yourself back. If after a long fight, you fall in the sin, immediately get up, turn to Allah, make a tawbah and move on. Make a tawbah, do a hasanah and move on. So you can replace that sin with a good deed. Don't sit back worried and all depressed and cannot move on in life. No, don't do that. And then whenever you are struck by a calamity, relax. Oh Allah, reward me. Say, Allahumma ajurni fi musibati. Oh Allah, reward me for this patient, for this calamity I'm going through. Allahumma ajurni fi musibati. Wakhluf li khayran minha. And oh Allah, replace this calamity with something better. This is patience in the face of calamity.